Up next on the workshop, a build I've been looking forward to since I heard they were being reissued, the 1/25th scale Tyrone Malone's Kenworth Custom Drag Truck, also known to us as the Bandag Bandit. Also available is going to be the Hideout truck, and that is right behind it. Now, I'm not going to get a chance to build the Hideout truck for this review, but at the end of the review, when we do the final on the Bandit, I'm going to do an outboxing of the Hideout truck so you can see everything that's going to be available. Let's get back to this bad boy here. Look at the size of that box. It's a huge, it's a big kit, a lot of parts also available. The Papa truck and the Super Boss have been re-released recently. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. First, let's do the funnest stuff. The gorgeous black molded drag body. That is lovely, and that's a very smooth plastic. Look at the reflections on that. I might be able to just clear coat that after we do the decals, but you can see the molding on there is beautiful, up to the high standards. Got all of our rivet detail, nice door seams, handles. Everything looks great on there, so we'll be able to duplicate the Bandit quite easily. We got that gorgeous hood with the scoop on it. And check this out, molded on the inside, texture, just like the real one because the inside was painted a different color. Let's pull up the back here. Of course, that doesn't look like a regular tractor truck, does it? No, this one's the drag truck. It's got the cool fifth wheel on the back. We got the underneath, which also has that texture. If you choose to paint that as it would be on the real thing, which I think is a light blue. Now, I am not an expert on these trucks. I remember my dad had Bandag jackets from back in the day, and this actually came to our town once, but from what I know about it, this is a black truck with like a blue clear coat, but you can do it just in black and be pretty much correct. We've got our interior tub here with that nice quilted interior and carpet underneath. There are lots of debates on the interior color. Some people saw it some years and others. So just go with what the instructions say or do a little extra research on your own. I'm pretty much just going to try to follow the instructions and go along with them with that firewall detail. We've got the big V12 turbocharged motor transmission. Look at that axle in the front. Belt and pulley system, hoses and lines and starters. Yep, this is a big rig build. It's just a not as big of a big rig build. I do like that the front suspension is all molded in place. Makes it harder to misalign that when you make mistakes. And we've got our rear part of our frame here. We'll have to put that frame together per the instructions, but it's got large mount all the way along. You can see the large mounting locations inside and out, so there shouldn't be any issue with squaring that up if you build it on a board that has squares or you compare it with a right angle. We got the nice Kenworth dashboard there. Check out all those gauges on there. We've got extraneous parts, shifters, all that cool stuff on there, steering column. These kits haven't been out. The Bandag Bandit, I guess, hasn't been out in a very long time. We got the Gigantor radiator on this thing. We got the nice bucket seats in there. Great detail on those. So if you've had an opportunity to build one of these before, you know what to expect. And if you haven't, you're going to find out in my review, because I always thought it was cool, and I still, there's numerous pictures of my dad wearing his Bandag jacket since he was an over-the-road truck driver. Drag trucks were pretty cool. We got transmission and engine parts on this tree. Front and back detail is still nice and sharp. You're not seeing a lot of flash. I'm not seeing a lot of flash. We got that gigantic oil pan. Looks like cylinder heads there. Fuel filter assemblies maybe. Hoses and lines, all kinds of cool stuff in here. We're not done. There's still more parts. I'm trying to untangle the trees on the side because there's so much stuff in here. We've got wheel backs. Yep, it's got smaller front wheels than it does rear wheels. And the other ones just fell off the tree. We got a giant pumpkin there. We got what looks like some suspension parts, maybe mounts. We're going to find out when I build it. We got the wings here. Those look awesome. Excellent sideways shape to them. We got the wing sides. We got what looks like a rear bumper. We got some air inlets maybe. Those are cool looking. So we get to put all this kind of detail. Here's our frame cross members all on one tree. And I checked in the manual and it does give color cross references for the engine, for the frame. Here's some more wheel backs we got going on. We got a black fuel tank. We got drive shafts. We got accessories, all kinds of cool equipment. Let me switch to the other side of the table, get out more stuff for this kit. Two big plastic chrome trees. Look at that Kenworth grill. Now you can go ahead, they have a decal for this in the sheet that we'll see, but you could fill that in with clear red and really make it look sharp. We got some very thin rods here. We got all kinds of braces. Check out the wheels. Smexy. We got the parts of the turbo here in chrome. We got airlines. We got the front wheels on there. We got some other small steps and braces on there for getting into the truck. On this tree, we've got our exhaust. Check that out. Molded open. Fill that with black paint. Wipe it clean. You're all done with the exhaust. We got headlights, what it looks like to me. Valve covers, it looks like on the engine. You can find the engine online. It's got chrome covers on it. It is decked out because it's a show drag truck. And then we've got the huge wing supports on this tree. Just massive. They look tight. All right, what else we got? We're not done. Still not done. We've got a big single glass unit and some clear red lenses for the taillight. We got the nice Bandag Tyrone Malone slicks. Yep, slicks on a big rig. These are your front tires. You got two of those, and we got four in the back. The white letter tires are very important to have on this one. All smooth wall, slicks for the drag, and that beautiful pad printing on there. Those are gonna look great. And finally, takes up the screen, the enormous decal sheet to make your life easier. We've got all kinds of striping. We've got pinstripes, we'll tilt it out. We've got KW logos. We've got everything you need, and everything is labeled, which wheel well, which door, which side of the spoiler. We've got two spoiler options. We've got this one that I want to use because I love the AMT hobby kits. And these are real. These were on some of the versions. And then we've also got, of course, just the plain ones. What I like to see is that a lot of these are just one large decal instead of just the pinstripe, so we'll have a lot less issues with tearing. They tell you exactly where this is going to go. They even have a little drawing on there for the spoiler. We do have some door logos on it for the Thermo King. They don't have Bandag or Detroit Diesel logos, but you can find those in other kits. So that is all set up with that gorgeous, huge decal sheet on there with Tyrone Malone's name. I'm going to start building everything, and we're going to be back for some sub-assemblies of this kit. Being a big rig kit, even though it doesn't have two rear axles, we're pretty much building a big rig frame and everything right out of the box, so it does take more fiddly parts. The engine has a lot more parts in it, the chassis has a lot more parts in it than your car model will. So what I say is, always with these older truck kits, the older ones, I recommend you have at least maybe a half a dozen glue kits to your experience chest, and then once you have that, you can crack open one of these and really not struggle at all with it. It goes together pretty well. Everything lines up. There are locating tabs, as we saw in the parts preview, and that's another reason why I like to do it. Ignore the white cloudy crust. I used some super glue on this to hold stuff together while the model glue dried, so it'll be a little crusty until I get paint on it. Clouded up a good amount for me, but they say everything that you see here should be painted a light blue, and I'm going to listen to them. I'm going to follow the instructions. We got our front steering axle in. We got our whole steering mechanism all lined up underneath here. It's all lovely. We've got our accessory and battery boxes underneath there. Unlike other big rigs where this would be completely covered with a big chrome cover, on this model the batteries are actually just like sitting out right there. So I will paint and detail those batteries because we will be able to see them for a little bit while we have the chassis ready. And that assembly goes together pretty well. The parts line up nicely. They all align themselves. Just get out your ruler or tape measure. Measure your axles diagonally. Make sure you have everything straight before your glue sets. You won't have any frustrating moments later. We've got this little control here. I don't know if it's the throttle. I don't know if it's the braking system, but that is there. That goes in the center. I'm guessing it's the throttle that he just hammers on it and off they go. We've got the radiator assembled. That thing's nice and big. That's two pieces sandwiched together and glued together. We'll be giving that a coat of paint. This is the only chrome stuff that you really have to glue together. These turbos and their lines are all in halves. As you can see, they come out nice when you just glue them together with some super glue. Clamp them and leave them alone. If you do get a little cloudiness from the super glue, go ahead, give those a coat of future floor finish, and you won't have any cloudiness anymore. But otherwise, the turbos are ready to go. The lines look nice. Those are well done. We'll set those to the side, not worry about them till later. You have two captain's chairs inside on these adjustable pedestal mounts. So that's them right there. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces go together, and that will mount inside the cab. Those look nice as they are. Getting to the interior of the cab where the seats mount, they have you put together a chrome roll cage. I was a little messy with the glue, and it didn't matter because I'm going to be repainting this. I'm not big hip on all the chrome in there, so I'm going to be repainting that more of a metallic color for me. That is your interior tub. All that we do with the interior tub is glue our firewall on, which lines up easily. There are tabs inside that allow you to line that firewall up on either side. Underneath are cab mounts for the frame, so that you can plop it on the frame like so, and it will sit on there unless you drop it off the side like I just did. But those line up like that underneath the cab and sit on that back brace, and that's what holds your cab in the correct position and the correct orientation. They say that should be black, so I'm going to be painting that black as well. We got the wing done. There is some glue exposed on the edges of the wing. That's okay with me. I'm going to be clear coating this, so it should cover that up, gloss it right up. I have decided to try not painting the body and see what happens. The wing goes together. Hope I got the orientation correct on that. I followed the directions. They were pretty clear, but I just wanted to make sure. So that will be sitting on its mounts on the back of the truck like so. Provide downforce when he gets screaming down the track. We got our batteries there. We'll get that out of the way. The only gluing needed on the hood are these side scoops. There's just 3 holes. If you're very careful with your glue, you'll see you'll get none on the outside. That means when we clear coat that, we'll be set to go. That is a beautiful piece. The grill will be going on here with the hood hinges, and hopefully we'll be able to maneuver that open and closed eventually. The cab doesn't require any work. Just make sure you really don't have any flashing, and if you're just going to leave it black and clear coat it like I am, you are set to go as it is right there. The rear body cover, the rear body on there, just needs this tail panel installed. You can see how it installs from the inside. It's got nice locator tabs on either end. Just glue it in place from the inside. You have a nice smooth outside. We'll be able to clear coat this and get that whole shell together. This will mount on the truck. See those 2 little L markers there? That's where the rear of the cab is going to go on. The front of this piece here mounts onto the back of the cab like so. There's little lips back there. You see those little flanges? So that'll be on there like so. So we'll hopefully get that all lined up, get it looking good. The giant V12, I left off all the chrome bits. Everything you see here, they call to be red. Even in the real one, there was a side picture online. Even the belts were red on this truck, so we're not going to worry about it. We're going to paint the whole thing red over the black. We're going to give it a good coat of red so that we can still see some of the shadow. Will make it look a little more realistic, and that is all set. So there's just some small little tiny parts on the side. We've got wheel backs, we got the hood hinges, we've got an air tank here, or a tank here that needs to be painted silver. So we've got that set up. We've got the what looks like itty bitty parachutes to me, so those are all set up. We'll stick those in the back. We've got a drive shaft that they said should be blue, so we're painting that up. We got the steering wheel and whatnot. We got, you know, coolant lines, all that stuff, so it's minimal. And as you can see, all the stuff on the chrome tree is supposed to stay chrome at this point. The manifolds, the wheels, the hood braces, the brakes, the brake cylinders, that gorgeous Kenworth grille. We've got side steps on the truck that are going to be going in. And of course, we don't want to mess with these nice one-piece wing mounts, the fifth wheel cover, the fan, the valve covers, the headlights, the exhaust are all staying chrome. So we're just going to leave those alone, leave those nice and shiny. I'm going to get into paint and we'll be right back. all those pictures jump us all the way up to where we have the frame assembled with the engine installed, the turbos installed on the top, the batteries installed and detailed. We got our wheel and tire package put together. The tires are more than soft enough. Feel free to assemble those wheels and then get it together. I left the back of the wheels black because honestly, we're not really gonna see them, and I love the chrome on the outside and the black on the inside. I did put the white letter tires on the inside just because I have them and have one out, one in on the duals, but that looks awesome underneath. It's all the blue except for the red engine, the black radiator, the hoses, the battery looks awesome. Got that in there. Got our engine with all of its chrome details since it is a show truck. We wanted to leave that chrome as it is with just some minor paint details on the engine, but that all looks pretty darn cool. Those are all mounted in place and that is all set to go. The work I did on that cab, like you saw, I did the silver trim around the doors, rubbed it off, used a silver Sharpie for the handles and the inner window trim, and then pushed the glass inside. Don't forget to glue in the little bitty glass. The glass up here, the cab glass, is held in with friction. There's chrome trim around the back window according to the pictures that I saw on some of them. The front trim is all black, so we're just going to leave that as is. And you can see that that stands out nicely, and then glue in your little handles or your footholds on the side so he can get up without scratching the body moldings. I did a little test with the future to see how it's going to come out. Let's take a look at the difference. There's the cab. There's the hood with the future on it. You can see a much smoother, shinier surface than the cab. So when we get the truck completely assembled, get the decals on, we'll go and apply another coat. Two coats on the hood won't hurt it at all, but we'll wait on these till we get the decals on them and get those installed. The back of the body doesn't really need anything except I put the tail lights on. That just needs to be installed. We got the fifth wheel cover. That's gonna go underneath like so when we've got that all together. I took the exhaust, I used some Tamiya black wash, put that in there, and that gives me a nice black exhaust system. The back of the turbos and their exhaust, I did use super glue, so it's a little cloudy. A quick fix for that will be when we get the cab installed and route our turbos appropriately. You'll see how each turbo will come along off the side here and down and out the cab and to the exhaust. It's going to come through like so. It actually comes through here. I can't actually throttle it through right here on camera, but it'll come through and aim straight down through those holes, and then we will be able to bolt that to the final triple pipe exhaust. Each bottom is keyed to the exact exhaust it should be on, so you'll get the sides correct on there, and you won't have any issues. We're getting the interior done while I work. I've got the dash detailed as good as I want it to go up. Shot it with a semi-gloss over that wood graining. When I lay the silver down with the silver Sharpie first, then the black, that's an easier way to do our trim rings than trying to paint them black and then circle a trim ring. Just fill in the center with black and your trim rings stand out. Then I took that silver pencil and just gave them little hashes for the gauges where we want them to be on our display. Gave the steering wheel a little bit of silver shine. The interior pretty much left alone. We're not going to see much of it. There's a little door clasp in there that I will paint up with silver in a minute, but other than that, just hit it with some semi-gloss, left the interior flat, did the seats in a semi-gloss, got those glued in place underneath. That's going to sit round about there on the chassis with the body over the top of it. That's when we'll know how far to push it down. So everything's looking awesome. I did reconsider and paint the roll cage silver. I can see in some of the pictures in the box that it actually was chrome or silver, so we went back with that. These little silver rods will go to the front of the radiator and support that when we install it. I'm going to keep putting things together. When I get the whole truck assembled and ready for decals, we'll come back for a look at it while it's still naked. I'm back with one last look before I start working on that giant decal sheet. Now, going off the box art and other pictures of it, there are many different ways you can do this model up when you want to go with your decal work. You have this gigantic sheet, of course, and it's just covered in all kinds of trim and pinstripes, you know, around the bumpers, around the doors, around all this kind of stuff, and the nice big blue and yellow stripes. Now, the blue and yellow stripes are the only things that I saw that were consistent no matter where the truck was or how it was being operated. A lot of other things were different. Sometimes it had no trim around the fenders, but it always seemed to have trim around the front bumper, and it always seemed to have the long trim around the side over the stripes, and it always had some sort of trim around the decal on the doors, and that, you know, and then you have these long triangles here. Those always seem to have decals on them as well. So those I'm going to use for sure. I'm not sure if I'm going to use some of the other ones. It all depends on how I'm feeling. You should make each model yours. One tiny little thing I had is that there is a gap in the body here where there should not be one. Now, I think looking underneath, and I think, and I'm not going to go back and start rebuilding it, we can see that my wheel wells in the back are perfectly lined up and they squeeze around those tires exactly how they should. My turbo exhaust fits in here perfectly, and when I line up my exhaust, I'm leaving these off, by the way, until the end, because one of the stripes has to come down the side of the hood, across the tank here, and all the way back. So I don't want to get this exhaust in the way. It's going to take forever to get the decal shoved up underneath there. But the exhaust goes up underneath here, and it has to curve around, and then it will sit. We'll get it on here on camera. It's really hard to do one-handed, two-handed with the camera. But it'll go up underneath there and join up with the pipe right there underneath the step. And that's how it's going to sit on there when we're all done. That is all lined up. Because to have the cab in the right spot, you got to have the turbos in the right spot, because the exhaust comes through the cab, out the side and down. So I'm not sure exactly where that gap is. I made a mistake somewhere. And the engine is in the right place because the engine, as you saw, locked into those frame rails. So that's not a problem. The tires look a little set back in the hood, but yet the hood lines up with the cab perfectly. You can see there's no gap there and there's no weird issues along the way. So I'm guessing maybe I put the hood hinges on a little too far back and that made me bring everything forward. But the exhaust on both sides is centered in there, so I'm not sure what I did. Obviously, I did something. I'm not willing to break the glue joint all the way back and worry about that gap. I'm okay with it. In fact, I can see a little bit of the blue frame through there, and it doesn't bug me. I'm cool with it. In the real life one, it's seamless. That's all one potty piece, and that's fine with me. So what I'll do is I'll pick out my decals. I'll get those going all over it. We'll get some door emblems on there. We'll get whatever blue pinstriping I want to put on there. We're definitely going to stripe the wings. I am most certainly decided in the beginning I'm going to use the AMT logo on the wings here with the pinstripe, because, you know, the kit's provided by Round 2 AMT. So other than that, it sits nice and low in the front like it should to scoop the air up and over. The plastic is going to look good with that future on, since I practiced on the hood, and that's going to look like real black paint, so that's going to be just fine. All I'm going to do now at this point then is start getting everything with the decals on, and when we come back, we will have the final. And remember, stay tuned after the final for that unboxing of the Hideout truck so you can see what's in that box. While I'm waiting for all those decals to dry on the Bandag Bandit, let's take a look at the Hideout truck. 1/25th scale Tyrone Malone's Kenworth Aerodyne. This is the hauler that they used to pull around the Bandag Bandit. You can see a picture of them together. You've got color reference pictures on the box for your decal work. It's a great looking cab over. Let's start going through all the parts. We'll look at this because I'm not going to get a chance to build this right now, so I wanted to get all the parts out here in the Bandit review. So what you can do is order this kit, have it before it goes out of production again, and then you will have a copy of yours so that you can enjoy it when you have time to go around and build it. Now that is a giant slug of styrene. Probably had to drain half of the Middle East for the oil for that. And that's good because models are worth it. So that is a cool looking cab. Sweet with the rivet detail on it. We got our tanks here. The styrene in this kit is molded in black. And then we've got some chrome trees and clear trees as well. We've got all kinds of frame braces on this one. It is a much larger kit, not only in part count, but in size, compared to the Bandag Bandit, of course. It's got to haul it around, so it's going to be a lot bigger. Check out that suspension. These kits have, you know, like four decades on them or so, and yet the detail is still pretty darn nice. And on these finer, smaller parts, shocks and airbags, I'm not seeing any flash to worry about. So let's get more trees out here. They must be keeping those molds nice and tight and well taken care of. We all like to see that. We've got a giant air or exhaust system here. I think it's exhaust because this truck has stacks on it. Two piece there. We got the nice Kenworth emblems. Check them out. Still strong in there. Can easily detail that. There we've got our engine and transmission halves. The black plastic makes it so much nicer to see. The cylinder heads there. What do we got down here? We've got an interior tub. Check it out. You can sleep on the road. Even got blanket wrinkles. We got our cab over cab with floor mats in it even. Carpet detail. Got the giant engine cover there. We've got our seats, which if you were paying attention during the other review of the Bandag Bandit on this video, it's got the exact same seat pattern in the Hideout truck. Got our seats and seat backs. Here we've got more frame parts, tanks, lines, body parts. We got a giant battery compartment there. We got more air tanks for the frame. Check that out. Look at that front axle. Holy cow. Giant piece of plastic, which makes it sturdy too. You can push on the model and adjust things when you're assembling it and not worrying about snapping off an axle that's only, you know, a 32nd of an inch thick. We've got some interior cab parts. They're just smooth plastic, but we're going to show you every part in the kit so that you know what's in it. We've got that nice quilted pattern on the interior. Flip that over. It carries out through the whole theme there. Just like the interior on the Bandag Bandit. They line everything up. Check out the dashboard. We'll flip it around here. Look at the detailed dash on that cab over. I mean, they've got even defrost vents. They've got the little compartment there. They've got all the gauges and equipment. And you can paint that up just like I showed in the Bandag video before. We've got our nice wheelbacks here in black. We've got more lines and piping. We've got exhaust. We've got the huge drive shaft on that thing. We're still not done. There's still a ton of stuff in this kit. Definitely get your money's worth with the Tyrone Malone kits. We got our radiator, belt system, fans, small engine parts, filters, hoses. We got a nice cowling here. Looks like the visor for over the top of the cab to me. And more black styrene. Yes, we got so many parts in this thing. Diamond plate done up beautifully. The detail's not soft. The molds haven't gone bad. We got our wheel chocks there. We got our winch detail. And the underbody has got all nice lining markers so you can line everything up properly. We've got the exterior of the sides of the carry. Check that out. Access doors, tool doors, wheel wells, and location marks and pins on the back. So you can get it installed straight and true, even though I still manage to screw it up sometime. We even got some ramps for loading the truck. We've got the tailgate there with just the lights on it. We've got another body piece here. Got a drive shaft. Awesome looking. You could make a whole diorama with those ramps. You could also use them in other stuff too. We got the other side of the carryall. Just a mirror image with the same doors and everything on the other side with the nice step-ups in it and everything. I like that about the Bandit too. It had those nice steps molded in. Here we've got our front suspension molded in, which will help us line everything up and keep those wheels aimed straight. And then we've got the big frame rails. You can see it's got numerous locating holes on the inside. These are much stronger locating marks than the Bandit had that we looked at, so this is very nice. You can definitely see where to line your frame up and get that thing. That thing is gigantic across the board there. Each one of those squares is an inch. We're still not done. We still got parts to take out. I love showing everything in these boxes because there's just so much of it. We got clear glass windows for the upper cabin on the cab over. We've got the windshield in there. And we've got nice clear clear red marker lights and everything for the body itself. Tyrone Malone Bandag tires. These, of course, will be treaded tires, and they're all the same size. The other side is no name, so you could always use these on something else or turn them backwards if you just wanted to make a transporter truck. You're gonna get 10 of those hollow beauties, and we've got a chrome tree. Oh, gorgeous fenders, mud flaps. Look at those, and they're molded open. They are beautiful. We've got our front bumper, super chrome. We've got our stacks all chromed out. Check out these thin little handles to climb up in the back of the cab there. Gorgeously molded, no big flash webs across them. We got that nice grill. We've got our marker lights all the way across the top, air cleaners, access handles, headlights, mirrors, anything you can think of is on there, just like the real thing. And to wrap it up, nice new decal sheet. This one does not have the Bandag logos on it, just like the Bandit, but it does have the Eaton logos. It's got the Thermo King logos. It's got the beautiful blue and gold and yellow stripes and all kinds of pinstriping, and they include curved pinstriping for you and a huge stack of straight pinstriping. So if you decide to do all the pinstriping around the rig, you can go ahead and do so. That is a gorgeous decal sheet. That's everything in the box when you get the partner kit to the Bandag Bandit, the Hideout truck. We will be back for the final on that Bandit. All right, here we are wrapping up the Tyrone Malone Bandag Bandit Kenworth custom drag truck. Doesn't say Bandag Bandit on it, but it does have the Bandag tires, the Tyrone Malone. It's got the sweet AMT hobby kits on the side of the spoiler, and I love that. I saw it on the real thing too. Otherwise, it does include the blue stripes that were on the box as well. So you can do this up a couple different ways. It's got that sweet decal sheet we went over, but this will be your final product. Now, as you notice, when I talked about it before we came back, I had a gap between the body and the rear cowl. I decided to take the whole body apart and fix that gap and get it to look right for the video, and hopefully it has turned out well. I have ended up with a super tiny gap in the hood in the front, but I will take that because now the tires are all centered and there is no giant gap between the cab or any kind of weird angles, and it looks a lot better this way. I applied the decals. I used heavy coatings of Mark Fit Strong, and that has worked out well. Applying those down, getting them down, I only broke a couple decals, and with this many decals and that thin and that long, you're going to break a couple almost every single time, no matter what you do. But otherwise, they all went on nice, and they have all settled down nicely without any big issues, no problems. I love that the larger pinstripes have clear carrier between them, so you can apply them without pulling your hair out. I chose not to do the pinstripes around the fenders or some of the more delicate ones around the door. Looking at the box art here, it did not have those in that photograph, so I left them out, but they're in the kit. You can do it. It comes out wonderful. I used the Thermo King logos because it really did need logos on the door, and even that, the pinstripe fits well over that side glass on the door there. The stacks look awesome on the side of the truck, the three giant lake pipes on each side. Those are cool. The chrome fifth wheel. The wing looks awesome on there. Little tip, the decals should go on first, then the wing can be mounted on the chassis. I did not do that, so I had to kind of squish and cut the decals around those two mounts. I didn't know they went that way, so before I started putting them on, but they came out all right. You got your over the cab decals that stripe down, run all the way down the back, and all the way off the back of the swing little tailgate there. Remember, the decals on the side, I would put the side decals on first on the bottom as my tip, and then from there build up with your hood stripes and get everything wet. I would do both the side decals and make sure they're sufficiently wet underneath that they slide. Then you've got one decal here, one on the top, one decal here, and one on the side. You've got two decals for your hood stripe and one on either side for the drop. That will give you time, if you keep them all wet, to slide them around and line them up and cut any excess if you need, get your decal solvent in there, and do your best to conform them to the hood scoop and down the side, and then they join up and run all the way down the side of the truck. That will at least eliminate most issues, and it will look great. So you'll have to go off the box for decal placement. There are numerous pictures on the box. I didn't see anything in the manual that said place this decal here, decal there. Also, you should know, any of the decals that have gold on them that aren't surrounded by white, like the decals around the rear fender, the gold kind of does disappear against the black plastic. You might want to use a different background on those decals to get them to show up more if that's real important to you. Otherwise, the kit is finicky because it's an older style kit and you should give yourself time to build this. It took me 3 whole days to build this kit. Usually I can bust out a kit in 2. This one was 3 when you added in the time on the decals. The future is brushed on over the decals, over the plain black plastic, and looks phenomenal. That looks like a painted black finish any day of the week. If you ask someone if it was painted or future floor polished over plastic, they would probably have a hard time telling you unless they looked really close. It really came out nice. I coat the whole vehicle with it when I'm done after the decals, and it brings everything into place and brings it all together and looks wonderful. So we are all set up. It's an excellent kit, but just make sure you do have experience before you pick it up, before you try to build it. At least I'd say a half dozen glue kits where you have to figure out a little bit of stuff on your own. These older truck kits will be finicky, and you will have to figure some stuff out as far as placement and adjustments that you'll need to make your exact kit come out fine. Thanks for watching the review. We thank Round 2 for sending this. This is a nice long video because we talked about 2 whole kits in the video, and this one takes a little bit longer to build. We will see you soon at the next review.